Good morning. It's race day, 6:45. I'm just about to go ahead and pick up my race number. Just checked the weather and it looks like it's going to be wet throughout. So about 80 to 90% rain, literally from the start right through until Sunday morning. So definitely going to be a wet one. The waterproofs are going to be out pretty much all the time. And yeah, going to be muddy on the course. But hey, you got to expect that when it's sort of mid-October, running into autumn, winter. These are the conditions you've got to put up with. So, right, let's go and get my race number. So I am just wandering down now to drop my drop bag off and to get my race number and get all the mandatory kit checked. My hotel is literally about 200 yards away from the start finish, so I'm going to go and do all that and then back to the hotel, just put my feet up for the last sort of half hour, get some more food and fluids on before heading back down here for race briefing and to get going. Big day ahead, well, big day and night ahead, and it's raining, surprise surprise. Here we go. In now, the course has started to stretch out a little bit. There's a few bottlenecks at the beginning, which to be fair is nice because it kind of makes you go a bit slower so you don't go off with all that enthusiasm and go off too fast. So now it's spread out a little bit, just settling into my own pace, picking a few runners off as I go, a few picking me off as well. But early doors yet, all going well. It's a light drizzle, got my waterproof on, but probably going to ditch that because it's really quite warm, so I'm sweating loads, which can mean I dehydrate, so I'm going to ditch the waterproof soon and then crack on from there, but all going well. So 15 miles in now, and as you saw, it's an out and back, so you end up passing the runners, which are running the other way. So everyone's saying well done and high fives along the way. It's really nice and sort of gives you a little bit of a boost. So that was really nice that we just passed the last runner. So no more of that until you're in turn route on the second spur, but all going well. First spur done, and it was a quick sort of in and out of that aid station at the town hall. Put a dry layer on underneath, changed my cap, changed my bath, filled up my bottles and the bladder, and then straight back out again really, because I don't really want to get cold, so get lost if I don't pay attention. So all going well, first spur done. And I was out of the aid station by sort of done 4 hours, so pleased with that. So well into the second spur now, so just over 31 miles in, 5 hours, 12 minutes out running. So this second spur is across the ridgeway, so we've climbed up onto the ridgeway, and it's really slippy underfoot, so we have to concentrate almost with every single footprint you put to make sure you don't fall over. Been alright so far, but can't promise there won't be any falling going on. So nearly 35 miles in, the old fatigue is starting to set in, so this is where kind of training comes into play and knowing how uncomfortable it feels when you sort of get to this sort of stage, when you start to get a bit dehydrated, a bit low in calories. But so nearly 35 miles in, all in all, going to plan, albeit starting to feel like hard work now, so digging in. So just come out of Streatley and Gorham Village Hall again, so out onto the third spur now, which is Ridgeway but the other direction. I got some food, changed the clothes again, changed the socks because my feet were really wet. I started to rub a little bit, so changed all that and now back out running. Starting to get a bit dark, so it's going to be head torch time soon, so I'll probably get a couple miles in now before I have to stick the old head torch on. Oh, so third spur, here we go, into the darkness. As you can see, it's getting pretty gloomy. Just over 53 miles on, so time for some light so I can see where I'm going. Just starting to rain again. I've taken off my jacket because it was getting too hot, but if it gets any heavier, it's going to have to go back on again, but into the darkness we go, and this will be in the dark now to the end. Here we go. Oh, so 65 miles in, out on top of the ridgeway, and it's chucking it down. It's really exposed up here, so really important just to keep moving so I don't get cold. Feeling proper fatigued now. I've had a bit of stomach sort of cramping and feeling a bit nauseous and stuff, but that's almost passed. I think it's because I've had some orange squash, too much tailwind, so I've moved to just water. Don't really feel like any food, so just grabbing fruit at the aid stations just to get a bit of sort of energy in me from that. Oh, and try and survive that until the end. Try and keep that dodgy stomach away. So it's 20 past one in the morning. See, I'm losing my mind. 18 miles to go now, so 82 done. Oh, bit of a climb up ahead, so kind of having a hell out of you. It sounds silly, but it's almost nice to have a bit of an excuse to not run. Oh, so yeah, 18 to go. Tired. So I've been into the last checkpoint, I'm now on 97.5 miles and my legs and body are completely fried. Got nothing at all left in them, just walking hurts. So literally I've probably got three and a bit miles to go, so I'm literally going to power walk it in. Because say running is really painful, walking is pretty painful too, but hey, I'm gonna get to the end of this. Time wise, better than last time, better than my last 100 miler. I wanted to break 20 hours, but with the legs being in pieces, that kind of slipped away. So just want to try and beat my previous time of 22 hours 14, so I'm on track to do that. So that's my goal I want to achieve. Three and a bit miles to go, still raining, power through these woods and get to the finish. But it hurts, lots. Run. So the 100 mile distance just pops up on my phone, so I've done it 100 miles. However, the bridge by the Thames Path, almost near to the finish line, has been deemed a bit dangerous, so we weren't allowed to use it. So the course had to be rerouted around it, which has added another mile onto the course. Joy.